also a published writer. And today I'm going to perform a written work that I recently wrote. So hope you enjoy it. It's called Anti-Colonialism. You tell me that not everything is shaped by colonialism, that I'm just simplifying the world to my agenda. Well, sorry, not sorry. You're wrong. You see, when you say that not everything is shaped by colonialism in a post-colonial era, you completely deny a plethora of things. And of that, you deny my existence. You see, one of the reasons why my skin isn't so brown is because I'm part white. When the British occupied South Asia, they brutalized the land and the people. And in that process, they inserted themselves into the Indian subcontinent area. This led to the creation of my mother's ethnic group. And also, hun, when you say that, you ignore the struggles in South Asia created by the British. The borders completely changed. You see, I'm not sure whether where my mom comes from should be considered part of Nepal or part of India, whether I should say that my dad's side of the family is Pakistani or Indian. You see, South Asia was left in a mess as a result of the Brits. The creation of Pakistan by the British caused a mass migration of people between different parts of the Indian subcontinent area. In that process, total bloodshed ensued. It couldn't have all been avoided, but the modern day conflict between Pakistan and India might have been if it weren't for those Brits, brothers and sisters of the same blood, fighting for a land that is rightfully both of theirs. You might have heard of Kashmir in the news recently. The conflict is still relevant in today's news. So when you say that not everything is shaped by colonialism, you fucking deny my family's history. You fucking forget the fact that I am created by colonialism. And through my lens, everything is as a result of this tragic history, and you need to fucking acknowledge it. And not only that, you deny the implications that affect everyday people's lives and fail to recognize that whether directly or indirectly, it has had and has effects on everyone in the world, including your ignorant ass. So next time someone discusses colonialism, if you have nothing to add, keep your mouth shut. By preventing discussions of colonialism in a post-colonialism era, you only perpetuate colonialism further. And this is especially true when I hear it coming from a white mouth, which is, from my experience, always the case. The only way to move forward is to acknowledge the past, learn from it, and use the lessons from it to better the future. Be not a part of the problem, but be a part of the solution. Conquista, go to hell. Thank you. Yeah.